for, you know, my own album. Mr. Curtis can only hold me for so long, so eventually, you know, he's got to come to some type of terms of negotiation.
Have you spoke to him?
No, I haven't spoken to 50 in 3 years, man. I done did every kind of thing that you could do, from calling a nigga phone to having lawyers reach out and everything.
Have you spoke to anybody?
No, I really want to just have a sit down with this nigga, eye to eye. We can do this shit personally or on ESPN or BET or MTV, wherever he want to do this shit. I just really want to look at this nigga in his eyes and really see what this nigga, how this nigga really feel about how he's going about handling me. Because I'm a real nigga, and this is something that 50 does know. You understand? Every one of them G-Unit niggas know how I get down, period. You know, it ain't no bullshit. Ain't no sugar in my blood. You know what I'm saying? It ain't no bitch nigga over here. I keep shit 100. I've always kept it 100 with them niggas. You understand? And regardless of our misunderstanding or whatever, however it may be, you know, for him, my biggest argument is, nigga, okay, it's a lot of niggas that have disagreements, but for you to try to hold me to keep me from feeding my kids and feeding myself and my family, then he's turning into the beef. That's what turns it into beef. And niggas know, when I beef with a nigga, it's not just with the music. I mean what I say with this music. Meaning when I see them niggas, I don't know what's going to happen, because he knows I'm an active nigga. And, you know, he got a lot of niggas that's around him that's doing a lot of ass-kissing to try to gain points. They funny to me. You understand? I listen to the 40 Glock, nigga, and pay attention to him. Nigga, this nigga don't know me. You understand? Nigga, you come around, you a Mob Deep nigga. You understand? He's a nigga that's been amongst Mob Deep. You understand? At least when I was there, he was never looked upon as an artist signed to G-Unit. But niggas pop a lot of shit trying to gain a lot of grinding points with 50 Cent. 50 Cent don't give a fuck about no 40 Glock. He don't give a fuck about no Spider Loke. Spider Loke know this. Hey, regardless of whatever shit Spider Loke has always said or whatever he done said about Buck, I still fuck with him. Because deep down inside, he know the truth. Banks know the truth. Banks don't want to be over there with the nigga. He just, nuts ain't cool enough to be able to stand up as a man to the nigga and tell the nigga how you feel. Yeah, yo, that's all he got. I understand why he washing 50 draws. Jimmy Iovine told me out of his own mouth, he'll never in his life put out a motherfucking yeah, yo album. So, you know, without cleaning 50 draws, he's left to be out there and try to find a nigga in Queens to clean they draws. And niggas ain't fucking with him. So he has no other choice but to be the 50 whore that he is. And I challenge that nigga to whatever boxing match. When I see him, he get it the worst, because he the one who been popping off at the mouth over these years. You know, he always wanted the separation and shit. You feel what I'm saying? Hmm. When he came home, you know, he viewed shit with Buck being in position. It was a Buck Banks and 50 type thing rocking out. Instead of him, you know, respecting the fact of us being group, he viewed me as competition. Nigga, I'm on your side. So it was always one of them things like, nigga, you took my spot. No, my nigga, I'm just doing me. And that's what he should have focused on doing, but he had hate from the beginning. So, you know, all of them niggas gonna be dealt with accordingly and in a real way, the right time.